Well, thank you. Thank you, Jacob. You're making my day. Okay, let's go ahead and get ourselves started for today. We have a couple of big things we want to do today. We're going to introduce assignment 3, and we're going to shift our focus around just a little bit, because we've been doing a lot of things to just sort of generate different types of forms and sort of increase our ability to generate all sorts of different shapes and forms. Today we're going to, look at something a little more fine. We'll look at really, once we have some forms, how we really control the color, the texture, the material, and how those things render. Okay, and really spend a lot of time thinking about how materials get assigned to all the different types of objects at different layers. Okay, we'll also go ahead and actually look at just how you create rendered images and some of the things you can do to control those different images. The biggest ones being sort of the overall level of quality you want the image to be produced at. And we'll find out that there's really a trade-off between quality and the time consumed to produce it. Okay, we'll hopefully kind of develop a procedure that says we'll start with sort of a relatively low quality to get quick answers and then ratchet up as we get firmer and firmer in some of our design decisions. Okay, but kind of learn how to approach that with a little bit of caution so it doesn't become all time consuming. We'll also spend some time looking at just lighting, because lighting is really one of the most critical things for renderings. And as we do our renderings, exterior renderings, things like sunlight take care of very nicely. You don't really have to worry about lighting too much when you're doing exterior renderings, as long as you have the right time of day and the sun's at a good position in the sky. On Thursday, we're going to come back and do some interior renderings. And then lighting will become very, very critical and very important to us. Okay. So in terms of what's going on with assignment 3, it is posted now, and there's actually 2 weeks to work on this one. It really won't take 2 weeks. It's not a huge assignment in terms of what's going on, because there's really just 3 deliverables. You have to come up with an interior view, an exterior view, and a walkthrough. Okay, there's only 3 things that have to come out of this. Okay, but we want to give you a little time to sort of play with this, kind of a little pause. You guys have been working so hard and producing such fantastic stuff. Like on the assignment 2 stuff, like you're blowing us away. There's really the level of the design work you're doing. You're not just sort of pushing the tools. You're actually doing very nice design work. So thank you for that. So we're gonna like say take that modeling that you've been doing there, rather than kind of doing a whole lot of new design work. We'll focus on that model, kind of work with that a little bit, and take the extra time. Oh, people were telling me that if I move the deadlines from Thursday evening to Friday. That's a lot better for many people who are in classes from Thursday from 8 in the morning till some of you 7:30 at night or something like that. Yeah. So rather than having really bad Thursday nights, there's a little more breathing room in there. If that helps you to have the Friday available, super. Okay. Don't take that as, oh, well, I got an extra day, therefore I'm expected to put in another 10 hours. Okay, now kind of the expectation is the same. It's just the idea to give you a little more breathing room at the end so everyone isn't such in a dead panic. Well, exactly. But this is one I would actually get started with the first part of this tonight, something like that, because it's or as soon as you can, because it's just you'll learn enough today to really get going on it in terms of yeah, right up.
What is the just in general, so we get an idea, what is the assignment 4 about? Just a general idea, so
oh.
In case we want to like start thinking about it.
No worries. Assignment 4 is actually going to be one where I'm going to give you a model that's sort of a little mini version of the Y2E2 building. Okay, and this is one where you're going to look at phasing and design options. We're going to look at how you build a project in multiple phases. So we have the first building, you'll build a second building and propose a third phase. Okay, and you'll also look at the whole notion of options that as you propose your building for the phase 2, that you can say, well, I'd like most of the building to be like this, but really for the auditorium, it could look like this or like that. And that really in a single model, you can entertain 2 or 3 different options. Okay, and just really use common elements, but then have a few elements that are different between those and sort of swap them in. Okay, so that's what assignment 4 is. It's all about phasing and options. Okay, no worries. For this one, yes,
sorry,
Mr. Farzan, what you got?
Only one exterior, only one interior, or is it just more than one?
It's really the expectation, the assignment is only do one, but please, knock yourself out in terms of whatever you want to go ahead and.
But that looks like so quick. You just have a 3D quick.
Well, we'll show you where it gets a little more complex today in terms of doing that. Okay, but no, this can be done very, very quickly, but this is one we're going to pay a lot more attention to quality of the finished images. Okay, so you're going to do an exterior view, and you're going to do your exterior view by first playing around with the materials and the textures. We'll talk about that a lot today. we're going to encourage you to sort of add trees and vehicles and side objects to your views so that you can give a little more reality in the same sense that you've been dressing the inside of the house with furniture and cabinetry and things that help give us context and scale. To dress the outside is actually very helpful too. You don't want your building to look like, oh, it's sitting out in the middle of the desert or in the middle of an asphalt parking lot somewhere. A little bit of context really goes a long way and actually often helps soften your building. Your building often looks very different in the context of all the plantings than it does just sitting out there all stark, kind of in the middle of a big blank field. Okay, we're going to create some perspectives and we're going to set up just the rendering settings, the lighting, the quality. Just play around with how you adjust the sun and the intensity of some things. So that's really, you know, what we're going to get to. We're going to create this exterior view and ultimately place it on a sheet. Okay. The second part of the assignments, we're going to do very similar sort of thing, but we're going to do it to an interior view. And the big difference here is really going to be more than anything, it's working with the lighting and sort of the quality of the light within the space, because we have just a lot of challenges whenever we're doing interior views. If you've ever been traveling around the world and you're taking photographs of your friends in front of, you're in some fantastic landmark and they're in sort of in front of a big plate glass window or something like that, and you take their photo, you get the photo back and you realize that all you see is a lot of light behind them, but their faces are completely dark. Because relative to the sunlight in the distance, okay, the lighting inside is not sort of tuned right. It's really kind of hard to sort of work with lighting that's coming through a window and have something that's sort of adjusted appropriately inside. Okay, and there's some tricks for doing that, and that's what we're going to play around in terms of lighting, how you can really adjust the lighting settings to sort of really pull out the parts you want to. When we do interior renderings or nighttime renderings, it's especially important because, you know, the range of light we're working with inside or at night is really so narrow compared to sunlight. Okay, that we have to sort of rechange the boundary, we have to recalibrate the light and get it to focus in so that we can sort of expand and sort of just adjust that lighting level. It's kind of like this thing that happens when you first come in from the bright sunlight and you walk into the building. It's kind of dark in here, but give it a few seconds, your irises recalibrate, you know, everything, or your pupils, I guess, everything opens up and you sort of recalibrate and rescale. Same problem when you walk outside. Yeah, at first you're all scaled for inside light values. You walk outside in the sun and it sort of hits you hard, and it just takes a minute for your eyes to adjust. Your eyes are good at doing that. Revit's not so smart out front, so you have to give it a little bit of help. The third piece of this assignment is going to be creating a walkthrough. And walkthroughs, you're going to get pretty quickly. And once you've established the whole notion that you have a fixed image, okay, and we're going to go ahead and show us that fixed image. Walkthroughs are really going to be just how I can take that camera and move it around through the model to do something interesting. So we'll walk you through the model, and what you're going to do is to go through and choose a path through the model where in about 30 seconds of screen time, okay, you can show us something interesting, and you can choose where that path is going to be. Okay, in 30 seconds, and I'm limiting it to about 30 seconds, okay, you know, you can't show the entire model. Yes, Jacob? Well, it's danger. Yeah. If you try to show too much, you're like on a roller coaster ride where you're racing around and jerking here, and you know, and it's just gets very, very disorienting. So you kind of want a casual stroll. I'm enjoying the view. I'll take in the panorama here. Maybe I'll do a spin. I'll come over here, and then okay. And here, 30 seconds later, we're done. Okay, we're going to limit it to that because if you go through and I say, do 10 minutes. Okay, it'll go through and take you, like 8 hours to go through and render this thing and run it and all that type of stuff. And really, you'll prove the point that you know how to maneuver a camera around in 30 seconds. Okay, that's going to be okay. So you can do a walk from the outside of the house into the house. You can do a walk sort of through the house, ended up out on the deck. You can start on the lower floor, and I'll show you how to do it so everyone decides they have to do it. You can walk up your stairs and emerge into the upper floor space. You know, everyone just tries different things. So go ahead and choose what's going to be about 30 seconds to you. It'll be it's a small piece. Again, don't try to tour the house, or it feels like a roller coaster ride where you're like just moving too quickly, or Mr. Toad's Wild Ride, something like that. Okay, so questions about the assignment?
Is
sir?
Inside the rendering that it does the automatic 30-second movie, we just give it the path and then what's the quality of the image that you would end up seeing?
What we're going to do is it's you create a walkthrough path. A walkthrough is actually the third option after a 3D camera, okay? And it just is a camera that is going to move along a specific path. Then as you create the movie, you could choose either to do it shaded, like we've been doing so far, or you can choose to render it. Okay, and set those settings. And I'll warn you, you got to think about, okay, in 30 seconds, we'll set it up so you're going to generate about 300 frames of movie. So you can see how long it's going to take a single frame to render, then you have to multiply that 300 times. Okay, and that's why, you know, if you're going to render your whole movie, and that's not the expectation, you'll see it's written that you can just shade the movie. Okay, if you render it, you know, it could take all day. Okay, so watch out for that. That's why, you know, when these people do this for movies, you know, when they render, they have farms of computers and they just leave them running like continuously 24 hours a day to do computer animation. Yeah, there's definitely limitations. We're doing sort of rendering on the cheap here. So, yeah, the expectation is that, you know. What's that? It's interesting. Is that true? There's more information to compute. Yes. So if there is more detail in it, but you find it's going to be really sensitive to light and shadow more than anything.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. They do. Exactly. Because in order to get light into inside views, you say consider all these inside light sources very carefully, and then all of a sudden, yeah, everything just like